Welcome in, Pirate fans, to a special podcast of Williamsburg Football, speaking with head coach Rob Woodward this week. Coach, I know you guys took a tough loss last week against Bishop Hartley, but I'm sure you guys were able to go back in there and look at your film and see some of these young guys step up and play. What did you take from the game last Friday night?
Well, the biggest thing I took from the game was just our guys got experience. They got experience making mistakes. They got experience having some successes at times. And they got experience playing against a heck of a good football team. We've got guys that's competed against them, and some of them competed against them last year. But a lot of guys, this was their first time to be on that big a stage against that kind of opponent. And even opening up at Ed Miller Stadium. So a lot of firsts there, and experience is something that you can't mimic in a practice. You can try to get as close as you can with the scout team that you have, but, our guys gain experience, and from that you're able to grow. From that you're able to take the mistakes and take what successes you did find. And we did as the game progressed, our guys stayed after it. They kept battling, and we had some guys that stepped up and did a nice job, both offensively and defensively. But that experience and growth is going to be extremely important as we continue to move on through the season.
Coach, who are some of the kids that you saw on film and during the game that you would like to tip your hat to this week?
Well, I'll start off with a senior. We've talked about a lot of young faces, but we got a senior in Jackson Coons that has not been on the field. He's been behind different guys. We've had talented guys on the defensive line. But Jackson's worked extremely hard in the weight room, worked hard in the offseason conditioning himself. Through the early preseason, Coach May had to really hone in and talk to him about things he can't do. These things are going to really hurt him, hurt our team at times. And Jackson just came out and played outstanding, I thought, in the game, just from an overall effort standpoint. He graded out extremely high for a defensive lineman against a very good offensive line. And really, it was just all came down to effort, him chasing down plays. Hartley does a good job of sending everybody to the outside. Well, Jackson was a guy that was able to, from the backside, run some plays down and make some huge defensive stops, save some plays from just a hustle standpoint. And if we've got 11 Jackson Coons out there on the field, we're going to be darn good at what we're trying to do. So I thought Jackson played extremely well. Adam Bastine, I've talked to Adam at the free safety position about some mistakes that he made. But Adam's another senior that is getting his first opportunity to really start and get out there. And he had a number of tackles last week. I think he was in double digits with tackles. Now, you never want your free safety to be in double digits tackles. But, again, Hartley does such a good job of sending a number of people at the point of attack, and the free safety is about the only one that's not accounted for, and he was able to step in there and make some plays at times. And then over on the offensive side of the ball, Eli Swords was somebody that was a fresh face, a young sophomore that's in there, very athletic, did a great job of hitting the hole, falling forward, making positive plays, and moving the ball down the field. And Aaron Masters, it's his first game to really truly start against an opponent like that at Ed Miller Stadium as a sophomore. There were mistakes, but there was also a lot of things that he got some experience with that only allow him to grow and us to get better with as we move forward. Kenny Sandlin stepped in there too at the quarterback position as a freshman and did some nice things in that drive that he was able to lead the team down and we ultimately scored on. Obviously they had some had reps some younger guys in as well, but that's our young guys going against their young guys, and our guys continue to battle and push forward and strive, and that's what you want to see when adversity is presented in front of you, to be able to overcome that and have some success there at the end, and we did just that.
Coach, nobody really understands how talented that team. I know I've heard of comments that head coach was saying this might be his best team that he's ever fielded, and you guys knew that going the schedule on the Bishop Hartley, we put you up against a tough team like that. But I thought that the boys did very well in their physicalness against Hartley, especially on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, yeah, that's two weeks weeks in a row I've been really pleased with our defensive play. And you say, how can you throw that in a team? And you have given up 74 points. We've had mistakes that's led to allowing, you know, some big play opportunities. But as a coach, you're breaking down every single thing that goes on throughout the course of a game. And yes, you've got to limit those mistakes because, you know, we've been a team in the past that's capitalized on big plays. Well, we were a team over these last 2 weeks that's given up a few big plays here and there that's allowed a team to continue a drive or maybe put a score in. We've got to clean that stuff up. But overall, I as you said, I like our physical play. I like our attacking downhill. I like what I'm getting out of the guys that we have out there. We've had some guys dinged up. We had a few more that got dinged up this game. So we gotta finish a game with everybody that we start the game with out there. That's going to be a number one goal of ours, and that's something that we've never had to face. Injuries has not been something that's plagued us, but this year has definitely come around to our turn in terms of the injury department, and we've had some freak things. So, you know, as a coach, I pride ourselves on our conditioning and our strength and our weight training, and I still feel that we're truly doing the right kind of things there. We've just had some freak injuries and things that's taken place that, we gotta look to continue to move forward and hope that those things don't continue this week as we move forward into Ashland.
Coach, one thing that could help the Pirates, and I'm sure everybody is trying to figure it out as far as a fan's concerned, but I know your coaches are working hard, is trying to figure out what the Pirates can do offensively so they don't put so much pressure on their defense.
Yeah, offensively, we just got to get people in consistent positions right now. And, we know as coaches, we've lost five or six skilled position players that we had starting off the season planned on counting on. And the skilled position players are the ones that absorb our offense and absorb all the different things that Coach Caskey's able to do with our offense. And when you take those guys out, when those pieces out, or you move one from, let's say, a Y position at the tight end maybe to an H, well, there's a new set of skills and things that need to be learned in that position. So we had to really backtrack and simplify the things that we were trying to do offensively just to have some success. And we did that, you know, last week and used the people that we had, the pieces that we had to the best of our ability. And we're continuing to do that this week and trying to figure out, okay, now what can we do with the people that we have in those places? And we got to get the guys there consistently so they get some comfort, experience, growth in those positions. And we're trying to find the best ways that we can to utilize those, and our guys are continuing to work. Our offensive line is continuing to work and do the things that they can. And we've had a great week of practice, and I'm looking forward to us moving forward.
Well, Coach, you move on to Ashland, and I know Ashland's 3-0, very good football team coming into Ed Miller Stadium. What's some of the things that the Pirates have to do to knock off Ashland this week?
We got to contain Pittman and Hester. Number two and number eight are two outstanding running backs for them. They got a nice offensive line. Both the running backs got a lot of speed. They don't have the big horses back there that Hartley did in terms of just overall size for their backs. But there's some track guys that's got some great speed. And then I'm really impressed with how they fly around the ball defensively. We've got to match that on our own defensive play and make sure that we're continuing to fly around with the ball and look to execute. We need precision, execution on special teams, execution offensively, and fly around with the ball defensively.
Any final thoughts before we get off this week, Coach?
I got to say I'm really pleased with the way our guys have responded to the adversity that they faced here early on. It's been, some tough times that we've had to really do some gut checks and really reevaluate. All right, how are we approaching this? How are we attacking this as coaches and players? And I really love the job the guys have done this week in terms of preparation. I think we've done a nice job of looking to step forward, move forward into week three.
That's Coach Rob Woodward with this week's thoughts of Wheelersburg, a football team that will take on Ashland. We hope that you guys are there to cheer on the Pirates this week as they will take on Ashland. Coach, now a lot of teams have moved from the 7 o'clock to 7:30 kickoff due to the heat excess. Is that something that the Pirate fans will have to expect, or are we going to shoot for 7?
Well, Gene, we start practice every day this week at 4 o'clock. And if you were out there, it was hot. It was very hot at 4 o'clock, and we finished at 6:30. So our guys have been exposed and conditioned to these type of weather conditions. I think 7 o'clock will feel like a definite cool down to them. So our plans are to start right at 7 and play. That's what we prepared for. It's what we prepped for. And you know, I hope that everybody can handle the heat as well as I feel like our guys will be able to.
That's awesome. Thank you, Coach, for this week, and we'll talk to you next week.
All right, thank you. Go Birds.